I'm going to turn the microphone over to our chaplain here at Cordova International Raceway, Lynn Garland, who will lead us in our invocation. Lynn, if you would, please.
Let's all bow our heads in prayer. Father, thank you for this beautiful day. Please bless all the fathers. Watch over each driver as they compete. Protect everyone on these grounds. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
All right. Thank you, Lynn. At this time, ask everyone to please rise. Gentlemen, if you please remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem. My, let's go racing. It is time. This is the IHRA Pro-Am Summit Pro-Am presented by AMSOIL. And here we go with our round one action. Going to kick it off with the hot rod cars, of course, and the car I've been talking about all weekend. I love this car, 1968 Plymouth Roadrunner out of Highland, Illinois. Tom Head behind the wheel. The year that Roadrunners were gorgeous, before they rounded them off, 72, 74, I'm telling you, they ruined the car. Just ruined it. John Erickson, Cherry Valley, Illinois, the odometer. Marley Mosier sponsored. Monza 1090 is the magic number they are looking for. And we're going to start off a pair of good green lights. Guard Head going to get advantage on the tree. Going to try to hold off that hard charge and Monza. It will be Head, 94 to the 93. He takes a whole shot win, 007 to 031. So picks up the win light right away on a big, big whole shot. Now Jay Wilson, mentioned before, second-generation driver, second-generation in the Sandbagger Wilson Family Racing Deuce out of Milan, Illinois. Brian Folk on the far side. The Folk Motorsport sponsored Camaro out of Durand, Illinois. Folk pulling multi-task today, driving at least two, maybe three classes. Oh, a red light for Wilson, six thousandths of a second. Too quick on the tree. Folk will take it out the back door with an 81. So he'll have to do a little of adjustment as the track is tight and good. Terry Toppert, Sherrard, Illinois, now in the tower lane. The Nissan pick-em up truck. You see the hole in the hood where the supercharged power plant used to be. Kind of switching it out. Ricky Rowland, the white safety universal roofing pick-up out of Blanchard, Oklahoma. On the top end, it's going to be a breakout for Topper. Just a little quick, 86 against the 90. On the Curry side, Rowland goes 91 on the 90 and gets the win light. Now Dennis Lynn Jr. We already know how much he's doubling up. He's running in that quick rod. Or no, I think he's running top dragster here also today. Long Motorsports sponsored team. The Beretta out of Bettendorf, Iowa. Got Lex Harris on the far lane. Chevy S10 out of Grover Hill, Ohio. the win light. He's 6,000 quick. Harris, oh boy, he's about 32,000. So Lund takes the win, closest on that double breakout. Will Crawford, St. Lean, Michigan, in the big block Chevrolet-powered Camaro. He's got Roger Van Erzevelde out of Brooklyn, Iowa. The Valley View Farms, farmer at Valley View. A lot of property that he's got the Whipple Hybrid seeds planted in. And they're a sponsor for him, too. They're talking with him earlier this weekend. He was here at the Nationals and just got everything planted so he could come. Now he's got everything growing, nothing left to do but sit around and listen to the corn grow, so he came to race. And he wins a double breakout by 2 thousandths, 87.4 to 87.6. So he's going to sit around and run in round two. Now Jace Deering. Little Ford Mustang out of Clinton, Iowa, facing that Camaro. Adam Folger, Avon, Illinois, is where he calls home. Boy, Folger has got a throttle stop that just knocks that car right into the dirt. And it's going to be Deering, 92 to 99, and that's not throttle stopping, that's just guessing the top end. Pretty damn good guess to run a 92. Patrick Forrester, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the Sunoco Race Fuels Monza. We roll here to the tower, Clarco Lane. He's got Wayne Christopher. Wiley, old veteran out of Milan, Illinois. If you run 1090 in the Midwest, you at one time or another have lined up side by side against this Monte Carlo Supersport. He's been a staple in 1090 racing here for a number of years throughout the Midwest, whether it's here in the IHRA or with the other HRA. Here comes Forrester in the Monza, and he's going to get the win light as Christopher's too quick. Forrester hits the number right there, 91 against the 90, and takes the win light. Doug Wood, number one qualifier yesterday in that standards testing lab sponsored Oldsmobile Cutlass. Ran dead on with a zero. Jan Winkowski, the runner-up just a little while ago out in the Lunatic Fringe car. Quick Rod, now this is your call. Quick Rod, this is your call. How about two cars, if they could hammer the tree any tighter, I just don't see. They are all over it. Oh, look at Winkowski, 90 with a 5, 007 on the tree. 0-12 package in round one. Coming off a runner-up, Jan Winkowski says, I'm doubling up today. He has just thrown down the big gauntlet here in round one. Once again, Quick Rod. Round one, need you rolling, please, Quick Rod. Round one to lanes 8 and 9. Jerry Rosenmeyer, Streamwood, Illinois, in the Camaro, facing the high-caliber Corvette out of Keshtocton, Ohio. That is Rick Pica behind the wheel. Throttle stopped, let go, but it didn't matter because Rosenmeyer was 2,000 in the tree. You saw that true wind light come up right away. So Pica saw it, you know he did, because he took it out the back door and ran an 81. Now Mark Erickson, Rockford, Illinois. Looking again also to double up this weekend. Jim Nobin in the far lane. The Camaro out of Holman, Wisconsin. Tool and die maker. My grandfather was a tool and die maker. Dying art for a true master craftsman. It's like plasterers. Someone that can put plaster on a wall. Dying art. Good side-by-side pairing here, and look at Nobin, 90 with a 1. Erickson, 89.8, 2,000 quick. Noden right there. here's another car. If you run 1090 in the Midwest, you have lined up against, I'm sure, that's Jeff Weitz, the Barracuda, out of Morrison, Illinois. Russ Gibble, the little Mustang Deuce, coming out of Indianola, Iowa. Here on the Clairco Tower side. Again, quick ride, make it rolling. And Weitz, 93 on the 90. Gets the wind light as Gibble was way quick, 88 against the 90. Once again, we need quick ride. Quick ride, need you to the lanes. The Friends of Cole. Greg Fowler, Point Pleasant, West Virginia. You know what he's doing for a living. He's digging, baby. John Miller, Waterloo, Iowa. What? Oh, can't go back and burn it. On the top end there, it is Miller. He had a perfect reaction time and then ran a 94 to the quicker, but losing 91 a Fowler. And it was a whole shot win. Perfect light to a 05. Took the strike by 200. So you do the math up. He had 500 on the tree. He was 300 slower and took the strike by 2. 5-3-2. The math really works. So Miller can count on that win there. Once again, quick ride. Need you, please. Quick ride. Need you to the lanes. Quick ride, please. All right, just going to roll right into our stock eliminator. Leonard Mattingly, qualified number 3. 1033. He'll dial a 34 in that B. Fuel injected automatic out of Kentucky. And George Andrebias, the D fuel injected automatic. Z28 out of Bellbrook, Ohio, qualified with an 8 under 1139. He'll put a 41 as the dial in against that 1220 index. Wind light here is going to be Andrew Bias. How about 41 with a 0? 015 on the tree, but Mattingly does the same thing. He runs dead on. But again, reaction time, 015 to an 037. So bam, both them cars dialed right in. Mike Lund, A, fuel injected automatic Firebird out of Bettendorf, Iowa, in the tower lane facing the gear pulling. B, fuel injected car, the Z28 out of Hookstown, Pennsylvania, Brent Borich on the far side. The Brent Dorch Motorsports Mickey Thompson DeFerrin race engine sponsored car. Wheels in the air for both. Another good round one side-by-side pairing, and this time it's going to be Borich. 62 on the 60. Lund right there runs 58 on the 57, but 200 difference on the tree gives you 17,000 difference at the stripe. Superstock, need you now. Quick Rod and Superstock. Superstock, need you to the back of the lanes for your pairings, please. Quick Rod, need to be in the lanes. Superstock, you need to come up for your pairings. Steve Blondell, the iStock automatic out of Moline, Illinois, going to take a wind light as Tim Dyer. The little M-Stock Mustang lights up the red bulb. And even though Blondell knew he had to win, he went ahead and ran it out. Goes 33 on the 33. He's ready. Denny Hillman, the I-Stock Camaro Ragtop. Zimmerman Brothers Racing, Cam Crane sponsored car out of Indiana. Guys, Drew Whalen, the Lucas Oil-sponsored Firebird. C, fuel-injected automatic out of Decatur, Illinois. Good green light for both. Less than 100 difference off the tree. And it's going to be Whalen as they both fall off big. He runs an 81 against the 75. Hillman can only manage a 78. Jim Thompson Jr., Davenport, Iowa. Driving the Jim Peterson owned Dodge pickup. E-truck stock automatic. He's got Randy Eakin. That drag pack Challenger out of Sykeston, Missouri in a red light for that double E fuel injected automatic. So Thompson will take a win in the pickup. As he runs it out the back door, goes 93 on the 91. Quick ride, you need to be in the lanes. Quick ride, you need to be in the lanes. Super stock, you need to be rolling up here for your pairings. Super stock, you need to be rolling in for pairings, please. Quick ride to the lanes. Super stock, rolling up to get your pairings done. This is your call. All right, continuing on now. This is Joe Shaxter on the far lane, local racer. Used to be, living out of St. Charles, Illinois now. Little Chevy Deuce, East Stocker. Bruce Castle, Naperville, Illinois. Mercury powered, 1971 Cougar. D stock automatic, the Wheatland Machine Sparta car. Oh, Shaxter, very late on the tree. Going against a veteran like Castle, it could cost him on the top end. Wind light here, and it does. He knew he was late. He took it out the back door. And Castle gets the wind light, 25 on the 21. Here's that little V. V is in victory. V stocker. You don't see them very often. 200 cubic inch power plant in that little Mercury Comet. It is a V stocker. I think it's a straight. I have to go look at it. It's a straight six. D stock automatic Chevelle. Tate Steins out of Calamus, Iowa. Jack Larson in the corner on Cropsey, Illinois. And it's Larson, 14 on the 10. And basically, Steins just ran out of track. Giving up, 5 seconds. On the handicap Ted Stark, you got to have more than a 1070 car. You're just going to run out of track. It's that simple. And he did. Dale Boreski, the Olds, 442 ragtop F stock automatic, facing the runner up from yesterday, Johnny Mike Dykema. The A stocker, Steely Performance sponsored Corvette out of Bluegrass, Iowa. And Boreski doesn't even look back and runs dead on. So didn't even see what was going on. Dykema got out and started having problems about 300 feet. By half track, he was pretty much done. Now Rachel Thibert. K-Stock Automatic, the T-Bear Racing sponsor, Malibu, all the way from Lewisburg, Kansas. Local racer, gear pulling H-Stocker. Rob Purple from Rapid City, Illinois. Brother Tommy works on the crew for Don Schumacher. But Rob, a great racer in his own right, takes one right there. Goes 7
for you now, 6 and 7. Super Rod, this is your call. Super Rod to the lanes, please. 6 and 7. All right, so here we go with Quick Rod. Your first pair, Pat Martin. Out of Loudoun, Ohio, the fabricator in the 08 American Machine. Sponsored by Armor Paving and Fast Loop. And over there in the Curry Transport side of things, all-silver machine, that is Dennis Foster. from Martin Grove, Illinois. All right, the magic number here, 890. Martin's machine, so Dennis Foster takes it, 92 on the 90. Better reaction time as well, 009. Vernon Rowland now, out of Blanchard, Oklahoma. The all-black car to take on that brightly colored rear-engine dragster sponsored by Choppers. Of course, Brian Robinson is a bar owner, so that kind of makes sense, doesn't it? The Rowland car, sponsored by Universal Roofing, White Safety, and Mickey Thompson. Robinson gets there too quick by 400s or so. And dead on for Roland. Next up, Patrick Forster from Pittsburgh, PA. And his competition over there in the Curry Lane is William Pitts. East Amherst, New York is where he calls home. And he is an auto mechanic. So some long distance drivers right here. Pretty close on the tree and at the big end. We've got a breakout from Pitts. Patrick Forster, your winner, 91 on the 90. Super Rod again, looking for you. Super Rod to 6 and 7. Super Rod again, this is your call, Super Rod to the lanes. All right, now Dennis Ridgway from Cerro Gordo, Illinois. He's a diaper man by trade. DRE Engine Diapers is his sponsor, as well as Mickey Thompson, VP, Lucas Oil, K&N, Locar, and Demers. David Dollum over there in the other machine, the 08 American Rear Engine Dragster. Ridgway takes it, 94 on the 90. Oh, Dollum quick by, what, couple thousandths is all. All right, Steve Geiger now. Amana, Iowa is home for him. Ron Folk over there in the Hoosier ATD, K&N, and Lucas sponsored car. Small block Chevy power for Geiger. Only 400 cubic inches. And a red bulb start for him. We'll make sure that Ron Folk moves on. All right, the very recognizable car. Justin Rees pulls up now. Clairco Lane, sponsored by Thompson Truck and Trailer and Roshwag.com. They are in Bettendorf. Craig Schultz over there in the far lane. The 2000 undercover with a 584 cubic inch Chevrolet motor. Coming down from Winona, Minnesota to race here today, this weekend. Win 92 on the 90. gets there by 0.05 of a second quicker than his competition. Travis Colangelo, now from Bayview, Ohio. The orange, silver, and other colored car sponsored by American Race Cars, Dave Elrod Racing, Sunoco Racefields, McCarty Auto Parts, and Penske Shocks. And that is Larry Byrne. His car sponsored by Auto Plus Parts Store. And he gets the win, runs dead on with a one, takes a race by only 0.02. And the buyer on here, Rob Bush, in that Dragon Asphalt machine, sponsored by Bush Lawn Care. So once again, Super Rod, I see you rolling. Keep them coming. Super Rod, need you rolling into the lanes, please. Super Rod, need you rolling. The 91 on the 90. 006 reaction time for him and his buy run. All right, now, Good Vibrations, Top Dragster, this is your call. Top Dragster, looking for you now in the lanes. Good Vibrations, Top Dragster, this is your call to 8 and 9, please.
All right. Well, thank you, Dean. Once again, Good Vibrations, Top Dragster. This is your call. Getting ready now. Going to roll into a little super stock action. So here we go. We want to thank Dean Fate, the new announcer here at Cordova International Raceway. Took over when that... Well, when that other guy, you know, retired, so to speak, when he said, I've had enough of this and headed on down the road, Dean stepped right in and said, well, we don't need that fat guy here anyway.
Nah.
Time for him to go.
I can do this.
Amy Falk, H Automatic out of Tennessee, the Camaro facing the little Mustang, Bill Dyer, local racer out of Port Byron, Illinois, the Reynolds Ford sponsor. Goes 03 pulling them gears, so he grabbed fourth a little quick and picked up the win light. Went through on the top end out the back door. Leonard Mattingly, Clark Company Auto Auctions, this beautiful old Achieva. Don't see them very often. Cox Creek, Kentucky is where he calls home. He was 1.3 under on the over-under. Matt Lund, H Automatic. Part of that Lund Family Racing team out of Bettendorf, Iowa. There's about as many of them running around here as there are wheat. There's about 1,200 wheat. Oh, Mattingly, one 1,000th of a second, too tight. Off the tree. So Lund gonna take a win light, and he lifts out and coasts through running a 90 against his 81 dial. Now, Mike Lund, I told you, there's a bunch of them running around here. Dad and sons and cousins and brothers. And GTE Automatic, another Camaro on a bench. The defending Super Stock World Champion out of Floyd's Knob, Indiana, the approved Auto of America. They both run 08, but Lund was against the 12, Stillings was against the 10. And you do the math, Stillings is closer. All right, next pair rolling up. Remember that Alltronics team. This is Fred Bartles. The Alltronics Pontiac out of Schaumburg, Illinois. Dean Messenbring. GT, J Automatic, Eastwood Auto Works. Sponsored Camaro, that one out of Rochester, Minnesota. The Alltronics team, always great looking cars. Always having those great cars. Super Rod, you need to be in. So Messenbring gets that one on that double breakout run. Now Michael Beard mentioned before, the Loose Rocker sponsored Villari, a past stock world champion, running super stock now, GTH automatic. Fred Bartoli Jr., GTH, another one of their Alltronics performance Camaros. Shot 01 to 09 takes the strike by 07. Easy to do the math. So Michael Beard picks one up there off the line. And look at this. How about there's only three in competition and they end up against each other on the ladder. Scott Pearson, K Automatic, Kimmy Atkins, and the Superstar. And now I'm going to bring in the other half. This is Eric Pearson, also out of Rochester, Minnesota, J Automatic AMX. Got Jason DeForest on the far side. Andover, Minnesota, GTV Automatic Cavalier, the Aero Awning Built Special. DeForest, 31 on the 29, taking the win light and wrapping up that round action of our Super Stock Eliminator. Super Rod, you're getting ready to come out. Good vibrations, top dragster. You should all be up in the lanes now also, please.
So our first pair of Quick Rod coming into the water box. Super Rod, my mistake. Yes, 990 the index. Delvin Shepard, of course, that little 57 Bel Air. It's 7/8 scale. It looks a little smaller. Brian Folk over there in the Camaro Roadster. Brian Folk's race by 3/100, 91 on the 90 with an 018 reaction. All right, Steve Otley now. 63 Vet Roadster taking on Jared Bauman over there in the newer style Vet Roadster. Bauman sponsored by Metro Harley. Pair of black cars. Both running big motors, Chevrolet Power. And Power brought in. Reaction time of a 008 takes the win there. Paul Brown now, Cass City, Michigan. The 27 Dodge Roadster here, Tower Side, take on James Wilson Sr. Another Corvette, 540 cubes, a Chevrolet Power for him. TC's Racing Trances is his sponsor, and Paul Brown thanks Champagne and Cooling and Power Glide Services. All right, Wilson Sr. takes the race, runs 93 on the 90. Yeah, a whole shot win there, and the margin of victory there, 0.004 seconds. All right, little AC Cobra now, Tony Malloy out of Williamsburg, Iowa, pulling up against Coshocton, Ohio is home for the high caliber 68 Camaro Roadster. To Price as Malloy gets there too quick by about 0.004 seconds. Almost even on the reaction time, a 0.010 to a 0.012. So it all came down to the breakout at the end. All right, Dave Johnson now, 09 Mustang. Jacob Elrod over there, 1992 Corvette Roadster, 555 cubes of Chevy. To take on 427 cubes of Ford power. Top Sportsman now, looking for you. Quick Vibrations, Top Sportsman. Looking for you now in 6 and 7. Oh, pretty well even on the tree. And a good side-by-side race right there. The win, both of them running 90 on the 90. And it was just on the whole shot, 0.019 for Johnson as opposed to an 0.026 for Elrod. Wow, good race there. Again, Top Sportsman looking for you now, 6 and 7. Good Vibrations, Top Sportsman. This is your call. All right. Excellent looking Black Nova. Ed Bausman, Tower Side, take on. Out of Bettendorf. Green light start for both of them. And Bausman gap and cannot take the win from Couch. Bausman gets there too quick by 100. Vernon Rowland, 85 Olds Calais, sponsored by Mickey Thompson, White Safety and Universal Roofing and Sheet Metal, taking on the roadster of Pat Martin out of there. Loudoun, Ohio is home for him. And that 27 roadster, Davis roadster. He'd like to thank Armor Pitting and Sealing and Fast Lube.
Hey, one quick note, Mr. Lagos and Mr. Bowman, you need to come up to the tower. You got money coming to you for that Division III North Star Super Rod bonus. So you can come to the tower and pick up your Super Rod bonus from yesterday's race.
All right, so Pat Martin goes red. Vernon Rollins sees those instant wind lights down at the track there. Once again, Top Sportsman, Good Vibrations, Top Sportsman, looking for you in the lanes. 6 and 7, that's where you need to be. All right, now Larry Bernshausen. Manito, Illinois is home for him in the little 74 Vega. Mike Lagos, Cass City, Michigan. All right, looking to double up with another win, but he cannot do it. He goes red. So he will not be back next round. All right, with the race run one, Bernshausen runs it out, does an 89 on the 90. All right, now Edward Rudek, Mount Prospect, Illinois. The flamed Corvette Roadster, sponsored by Central Car Clinic. Alan Miller is over there in the 27 Brogy Roadster, hailing from Marshalltown, Iowa. Well, as you can see from the, he was way out in front with a better light. And he will take the win in the end there, runs dead on with an 8, and gets the race by 9 hundredths. But it was all over right from the line, even though he didn't notice yet. All right, Dave Dollum now, 57 Corvette, 427 Chevy motor there. Tom Diamond from Dublin, Ohio, over there in the 27 Ford T Roadster, sponsored by Armor Paving and Sealing, Fast Cope Oil Change Center, and Water Sports. And the win goes to Dollum.
What the hell's going on? And get yourself one. $3 pork chop sandwiches available right now. All right, here we go. How about the fastest of the IHRA sportsman classes? Such a popular class that some years back the NHRA said, well, we got to start running them because they didn't know what the hell else to do. But here we go, and we've had some quick ones. We've got cars running in the sixes. We've got 200-mile-an-hour cars. Right now we got Benny Smith, LaSalle, Ontario, Canada. Tower Lane, 33, the dial on the car. He's facing the 685 of Bill Black, the complete automotive racecraft chassis-built car. He ran in the 80s at 201. To qualify yesterday and today, number two qualifier. Double O lights for both. And Smith looked like he was a trouble, but then pumped it a little bit. But Black is going to hold on for the wind light. They both fall off the dial just a bit. It sounded almost like Smith pedaled a little bit. Next pair now, Anthony Lane already has an Ironman from the weekend in this top dragster class. 716 the dial for that nitrous-fed Chevrolet out of Coal Valley, Illinois. He is facing the number one qualifier yesterday and today. The big supercharged Rodec power plant of Don Spear. The chassis concept car at Demport, Iowa, 665. He's got a 10th on the whole field. No one is closer than a 10th. Oh, nearly identical on reaction times. Couple thousand. That's a strike. It's going to beat Anthony Lane. 18 on the 16. Spear goes 67 on the 65. Anthony Lane will take the stripe by 9 ten-thousandths. Of a second at almost 200 mile an hour. We're talking inches. Less than half the distance of the front cone on that dragster. Wow. What a race that was. 9 ten-thousandths the margin at the stripe. Chris Sullivan, Auburn, Illinois. Big block Chevrolet. 713 the dial. He's got Anthony Elrod, part of that Sunoco Race Fuel stable. Out of Harrod, Ohio, the Elrod family representing Sunoco Fuel. 733 is the dial on the Curry side. On the 13-022 package. So a very nice lap there for that Sullivan family racing team. Will Crawford in in the tower lane, another big block Chevrolet-powered car. This is a diamond-built car out of Saline, Michigan. He's got Tony Fraser on the far side out of Davenport. The Total Aquarium Maintenance Chassis Concepts sponsored dragster, local racer. 17 is the dial for him. So he will chase. So here we go, Crawford. We'll take the handicapped head start here on the Clairco side of the racetrack. Again, good green light. Fraser gets a small advantage off the train on the top end, and it's just enough as he takes a hole shot win. 19 on the 17, goes double O against the 0-2 of Crawford, who runs dead on. Gets the stripe by 7 thou. So Fraser hammers the tree and is able to take it on the top end. Hot Rod, round two. This is now your call. Hot Rod, round number two. Looking for you now in the staging lanes, please. Hot Rod, round number two. This is your call. Hot Rod. Hot Rod to the lanes now, please. Hot Rod to the lanes. All right, continue on here in this Good Vibrations top drag. 744 to Ed Smith. Another racer out of Ontario. He's the wrong number in the box. He had to have. With a 125 reaction time, he spun the wrong number and knew it, took it out the back door and broke out. Smith lifted and gets the win. So a tough break there for Marsden with a 125 reaction. The usual thing is, yeah, spun the wrong number or didn't clear the box from the first round. From the qualifying, there was probably something set wrong in the delay box. Terry Crews, number two qualifier, 686 the dial for that Chevrolet-powered M&M built Sinister Act. You've got Dennis Lung Jr., part of that Long Motorsports stable. Crews chasing, Crews in trouble. Lung gets the win. Boy, Crews right about 1,000 foot. You heard the car. It just slogged out and just, it didn't come to a complete stop, but you knew it just went nowhere. It dropped straight out. Crosses at 115 mile an hour, so just died a bad death at about 1,000 foot mark, which allows Lund to take it on for the win. Chris Cadel, number two in the world in this top dragster class. Nitrous Express, Lenore Racing Transmissions, Extreme Paint, and UAW Region 1A. He's got Howard Schluter, the Verona, Wisconsin racer. And it's going to be a win like for Cadel. 42 on the 41. Schluter gets there first, but he runs a 55 against his 57. Did not have it covered. Lifting wouldn't have done a damn thing, so he just hung on. Didn't have enough to lift out of. So he was on the trailer pretty much no matter what. Travis Coangelo, man, Travis, I'm so sorry. I butchered that name this weekend. I butchered it at the Nationals. I butchered it here. We're going to Travis C. That's how it is. Bayview, Ohio racer. I know, Johnny, it's four syllables, and you, Coangelo, I know. And I say it to myself in my head, and then when I open my mouth, it comes out. So Travis, I can't say that. So Travis C. Travis takes the win, so I've got another round to destroy his name in. All right. So a good run there for Travis. He goes 41 on the 39, 004 against the tree. Takes a strike by 22, 10 thousandths. Yep. He'll be back. We're going to have to give him a different name. He's Travis C. Well, it's like in the when we're doing the Nationals and the Pro Mod racer, has got a name that the Russian's got a name that's as long as can be, man. He's Ruben. He's Ruben T. That's all I call him. Ruben T. Oh, is he building it? There you go. So Travis from American, there you go. He's building the car that the Summit Super Series champion is going to win this year. Because they always give a dragster away. And he's working on that car. There, my favorite car. That should have been best appearing. I'm sorry. I love this dragster, Dustin Meyer. Out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. We've been talking about it all weekend long, but I'm telling you, you take a dragster and roll into a rat rod show and win, you could win best appearing. How many times have you seen rust that's got clear coat on it and shiny? I love the paint job on that. I just love that car. Someone will roll up and, God, what a barn find. No, this was meant to be. He's got Jacob Elrod, the other part of that Sunoco race team out of Herod, Ohio. I won't get to see him anymore, but that's all right. Been looking at it all weekend. I just love that car. I really do. I would have awarded it best appearing, but I'm not a judge. But, I just love that car. Now, talk about paint jobs. If he's known for nothing else, Bobby Inch is definitely...
When you own a body shop.
Known for paint jobs. Not only on his dragster here, but he's got a beautiful Chevelle.
67,
that's
66.
That's got a gorgeous paint job on it. His son's junior dragster matches his dragster. I mean, if you want to talk about beautiful paint job.
So does his daughter, Hannah's.
Bobby Ince always comes out. That Ince team always comes out with absolutely beautiful cars. I forget, okay, and the daughter's junior. We got it. Calm down.
Talked about Hannah.
So Ince is going to take the Byron here in this Ince Towing Chassis Concepts built car out of Kewaunee, Illinois. 709 is the dial he puts on it, and he's just going to take it right out the back door. He's going to go 11 against the 9. Once again, Hot Rod, Hot Rod, Hot Rod, Hot Rod. Hey, Jake, how are you? Happy birthday, just a couple days ago, wasn't it? Yeah. Jake Ashew, a former employee at one of our sister tracks of Cedar Falls Raceway. Used to be a sister track, now still an IHRA track. Got a big race coming up next month. Their Night of Fire is happening. Couple old friends here of Curdover International highlighting the show. We're talking about, of course, Jack Wyatt. One of the only Nitro Funny Car drivers out of the state of Iowa. And he's taking on an Illinois favorite, a Midwest favorite. And that's a two-time IHRA Funny Car World Champion in Dale Peanut Creasy Jr. They'll be pairing up here in a few months. Stock, I need you to the back for pairings, please. Stock, this is now your call. The back of lanes to get your pairings done. Stock. To the lanes, please. All right, now how about a little good vibrations? Top sportsmen, the fastest door slammers in the sportsman categories. Lou Roush, qualified number 4 with a 71. He's going to put a 68 because he knows that track is hooking. The Beretta out of Traer, Illinois. They've got stuff to play with. They can go as fast as they want, but they can only dial against slower, about a tenth slower than their fastest qualifying run. Rupert Allman, South Point, Ohio. Brings the Firebird in, qualified with a 76, and he will dial a true 76 on that car. They took that back window out, and it makes it look almost like a pro mod, like it's got a great big long deck. Not quite a pro mod deck, but it just appears to be. Top end there. Oh, it's going to be Allman. Dead on, 76 on the 76. Roush. Beat him off the tree, but could not run the number, and can only manage a 71 on the 68. So Allman gets the win. All right, now, Rich Kent looking to double up. He already has an Ironman from the weekend in that supercharged Ford-powered Comet out of Aurora, Illinois, but and he's got his hands full with Jeff Sutherland. Nitrous-fed, Chevrolet-powered Cutlass. Local racer out of Andover, Illinois. Went deep in rounds yesterday. Went deep in rounds at the National. Also, saw him down in Florida at Brainerd. The Southern Nationals at Palm Beach. At the Palm Beach Nationals, he went deep in rounds there. So you see him venting off a huge amount. So nitrous-fed Chevrolet facing supercharged Ford Power. 73 and a 70 are the dials. It's going to look heads up. You'll just barely be able to see the difference in the bulbs as they come down the tree. With a zero on the 73, double 08 on the tree. Holy cow, a double 08 package. I told you, that super, that nitrous-fed Cutlass of Sutherland is a tough draw. He lines up beside you, you're going to have to bring your A game. Rich Kent brought a little too much of his A game as he was just wrecked. Don Swindle, police officer out of Mentor, Ohio. The Eisen Racing engine sponsored S10. Qualified with a 76. Not sure what he's dialing. He's dialing a 74. Steve Moss, the Firebird. We mentioned yesterday, had all kinds of problems. Drug his laundry down the track twice. He qualified with a 54. Had a good pass this morning, and he puts a 54 on the car. So Moss will chase. Swindle will take 2/10 on the tree. Oh, but Moss will take about 6,000 of it back. Seven on the 54. He takes the win. Swindle falls way off. Can only manage an 82. And a 74 dial. Now Scott Oxis. I absolutely love this car. This Camaro turbocharged out of Santa Clarita, California. They're still working on the combination. They're still working on the tune-up. Struggling a little bit. Qualified with a 961, which means absolutely nothing. He puts a 7 flat because they know once they hit the tune-up what this car is going to do. They've got a fairly decent idea. It's just finding the timing, the clutch setup, just finding the actual what they can make this thing do. And they haven't reached it yet. But on the far lane, runner-up already this weekend, John Hochstetler, nitrous-fed, Mopar-powered, Stratus RT, and you see him venting it off. Wants a good shot. Ran a tight race against Rich Kent earlier today in the finals of yesterday's Top Sportsman. So it's a 7 flat and a 703. Again, it'll look heads up. Last pass that Ox has made, he shook the tires about 70 feet out, and I mean shook them. Ran right over him. So bringing up the boost on that turbo car, pumps it in. And he does it again, just rattles the tires. He's just about got it, man. He's got the wheel speed. He just can't get it to relate all the way down. And Hochstetler lifts up a little bit. He runs a 30 against the 03, but he saw at about 400 feet that Oxis was out of it. But, man, you could see it. It was really grabbing good at a 102 short time, 284 at the 330, so had good numbers. But then them tires, it just got up. He lost a little traction, and there's no way to pedal a turbo car. Once you lose the traction, you're done, and it started to rattle. Went from good tire speed to tire spin, and there's a difference between the two. There's a major difference between tire speed and tire spin. You want tire speed, You don't want tire spin, and that's what happened. You can see the chatter marks where it just got up there and started to spin instead of speed, and that's what happens. It rattles, and your eyeballs do that goofy thing. It looks like a bobblehead, and you get out of there, and you make sure all your teeth.
No matter what you drive, Summit Racing Equipment has great parts at great prices. Summit Racing has the lowest prices guaranteed on the parts, tools, and accessories for high-performance cars and racing, trucks and off-roading, daily drivers, late model vehicles, and more. With over 900 brand-name manufacturers to choose from, you'll always get great parts at great prices. Plus, you'll find money-saving deals on thousands of in-stock parts every day. Get the best parts and accessories for what you drive at Summit Racing. Visit summitracing.com.
First pair, pulling into the box. Tom Head out of Highland, Illinois. The super clean Roadrunner, 440 Mopar engine. Jan Winkonski, there. 1972 Chevy Nova, Lunatic Fringe. Cheek Tanaga, I believe, New York. 1090, that magic number. Oh, good lights on the leave. Winkowski, the better one. Double breakout with a perfect reaction time. He goes less under than Tom Head does to take the round. Brian Folk now, Clerco side. The Folk white Camaro. Rick Pica over there, the flamed Corvette out of Coshocton, Ohio. He's retired, and his car is sponsored by High Caliber. It's a double breakout race, and Brian Folk, the lesser of the two evils, as he runs one under. Roger Van Ersvelde, I believe, out of Brooklyn, Iowa. Sponsored by Tribal Centers of America. Whipple Hybrid Seeds and Valley View Farms, taking on the Mustang of Jay Steering. And the farmer will get it as the camoed Mustang is four off compared to one off for Ersvelde, Van Ersvelde. All right, Patrick Forrester now, Sunoco Raceville sponsored, Little Monza. Brittany Rowland over there from Blanchard, Oklahoma. The white little S10 sponsored by White Safety and Universal Roofing. Quick Rod, looking for you. Quick Rod, looking for you. All right, advantage to Forrester on the line at the big end of the track. It's a win for him. Rowland gets there too quick anyway. As she goes one under. Quick Rod, again, need you rolling. Quick Rod, need you rolling. All right, Jim Nobin, bright orange Camaro. And as Bob Fry will tell you, there is no word in the English language that rhymes with orange. All right, Jeff Wheat's over there, the 70 Cuda.
Now, if you grew up watching HR Puffin stuff, you'll know oranges, porringes, who cares?
So much for Bob Fry's philosophy on that one. All right, Wheat's out in front. At the end of the strip, looks like he's going to take it. A 91 on the 90 by a hundredth. Yeah, big hole shot there. 022 to an 048. right. Dennis Lund Jr. now. Great looking laser straight little 91 Beretta of his. And John Miller over there in the Curry Transport Firebird. 1990 Trans Am. Bowtie power for both of our racers here. Competitive on the tree here. The track, a double breakout race. Dennis Lund Jr. gets it. 83 on the 90 compared to 80 on the 90, so 10 under for Miller.
Once again, Quick Rod. Need you rolling now, please, the lanes, Quick Rod. This is your call, lanes 8 and 9, 990 car, I'm sorry, 890, quick rod, 890, this is your call. And Superstock, you can come into the back for pairings. Quick Rod and Superstock. Quick Rod to the lane, Superstock to the back to get your pairings done. Quick Rod and Superstock, this is your call now, please.
All right. Well, I just been informed you got about 15 minutes to get down there to Novelty if you're interested in any of the wearables that we've got, or sunglasses, the new bug soother or shower kits, any of that stuff. 15-minute call on Novelty. 15-minute call on Novelty.
Talk about a breakout. You're going to do it. By God, do it right. Don't mess around. Forget this breakout by 1,000 or breakout by a full 10. You're going to do it. Do it up big. All right. Next pair now, Bruce Castle. D-Stock Automatic, that Mercury-powered Cougar, the Wheatland Machine-sponsored car. Got Rob Turkle, local racer, out of Rapid City, just down the road a few miles. H-Stock Camaro. Pulling the gears all the way down the track. Once again, Quick Rod, we need you. Quick Rod. Quick Rod to the lane. Superstock to the lane. Quick Rod and Superstock. Oh, my. Turkle hammers on the tree. Gets the wind light. Lifts out on the top end. They both fall way off the dial. But he lifted out at a big advantage on the tree and took the wind light. Quick Rod, Superstock. Quick Rod and Superstock, we need you, please. All right, another one of my favorite cars this week. This is a gorgeous 442 convertible. Daryl Boreski out of Elgin, Illinois. He's got Jim Thompson Jr. He's driving the Jim Peterson-owned E-Truck stock automatic out of Davenport, Iowa.
The old Zeven's got Dr. Olds on the side.
And making their way toward the top end now. Winlight is going to be Thompson. He goes dead on 94 on the 94. So Boreski will load the 442 into the trailer. Now, something you don't see real often, a fuel-injected manual transmission. And that's Brent Dorich. This is a B fuel-injected car, the Z28, out of Hookstown, Pennsylvania. George Antrobias on the far side, D fuel-injected automatic. He's out of Bellbrook, Ohio, another little Z28. This one at 89 compared to Dorich's 94. So they qualified number 7 and number 12, respectfully. Oh, and Antrobus, boy, he just dies. And look at Doris. He knows it. He stepped on the brake, coasted through with an 11.95. As soon as he saw Anchor Bias had a problem, boom, he shut her down. He knew the race was his. So a win like there for Derek. Not sure what happened on the far side. And now the Byron Steve Blondell. Number one qualifier with a 1 point or minus 1.28 under of that iStock automatic Camaro out of Moline, Illinois. 11:33 the dial. He's going to come to the top end with 31, but on a bye, you can break it out. You can red light. Action. This is Dennis Ridgway. Sierra Gordo, Illinois. The DRE engine diaper sponsored dragster. You've got Larry Bernschossen. Auto Plus Parts Store sponsored dragster out of Manito, Illinois. As we get in now into our quick ride class, the fastest of our index classes, 890 is the dial. Four against the 91 of Ridgway. 5 thou at the stripe. 023 package for Bernschossen. Very nice lap there. So a little break here. We got little debris out on the track. We're going to clear real quick. All right, well, safety crew had a little debris up on the top end, so we'll run up there and get it cleared. We want to welcome everyone that is following along online on Motor Mania Television. Want to, of course, welcome Joanne and Mark back here to Cordova International Raceway. I've been here since last year, so it's good to have them back on the grounds, able to look at it and see Adger Smith, an old friend of Cordova, to race back here back in the day quite a bit. So good to see Adger on there. And, of course, Rooster, all the others that have been following along the racing all morning. Zach's on there. And, of course, Motor Mania's on there. Rooster's on there. So everybody following along, not able to make it live here to the track. To folks, 91.4, 006 to 009 on the tree gives you 11 ten-thousandths at the stripe. Boys and girls, it don't get a whole lot closer than that. Wow, what a great pair that was. Now Dennis Foster, Morton Grove, Illinois. Patrick Forster, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Matching up, both driving American chassis-built cars. both driving big block Chevrolet powered cars. 4,000 dip on the tree. So again, it's a number on the tire together, and it's going to be Foster 90 with an 8. Runs the dead on number and takes the win light. Justin Reeves, local race starter, Davenport, Iowa, the Thompson Truck and Trailer, RVSwag.com, sponsored dragster. Vernon Rowland, Universal Roofing, white safety, sponsored Moldenbilt dragster. He's coming out of Blanchard, Oklahoma. Over on the far side in this quick ride round two action. Gets a jump on the tree. Double 09 014 package. Man, these guys are running today. Double O lights, dead on dials. That's just what you like to see and hear. So that wrapped up our round two. Super Rod. Super Rod. We'll take you to the lanes now, please. Super Rod. This is your call. Super Rod to the lane. Once again, Super Rod, we need you rolling now, please. Super Rod. Super Rod to the lanes and top dragster. Super Rod and top dragster, this is your call. Super Rod and top dragster to the lanes. How about a little super stock action? Michael Beard, GTH Automatic, was tough at the Nationals here this year. That loose rocker sponsored the line. Matt Lund, part of that Lund family racing team. Top end here. It's going to be a double breakout, and Lund is going to get the win light. Once again, out in the pit area, top dragster, top sportsman, and Super Rod. Super Rod, good vibrations, top dragster, good vibrations, top sportsman. Need all of you. Super Rod, top dragster, and top sportsman. This is your call, please. Dean Messenbring, GTJ Automatic. Bill Dyer, Superstock N. Super Ride, top dragster, top sportsman. This is your call. Side-by-side pairing, and this time it's going to be Dyer. Goes 0-2 on the 99 and picks up the win light. Scott Pearson, the K Automatic AMX, Stuartville, Minnesota. Qualified 11-04, put the 1081 on it for this round action. Facing the world champion, the Grand Am, A Modified out of Floyd's Knob, Indiana, Scotty Stillings. Doing the driving. True wind light, come on. Once again, Super Rod, top dragster, and top sportsman. Super Rod, top dragster, and top sportsman. Need you rolling to the lanes, please. Super Rod, top dragster, and top sportsman. And now the buy run. This is Jason DeForest, GTB Automatic. The Aero Awnings, Billet Specialties, Aero Fast Inc. little Cavalier out of Andover, Minnesota. 9 flat is the dial, and 9:38 is the lap to wrap up that round action. Again, Super Rod.
All right, Super Rod competition continues here with Larry Brinshausen out of Manito, Illinois, pulling up in the Vega. Brian Folk over there, Roadster Camaro. Very slight advantage on the tree to the little Vega. It's a double breakout race. Brinshausen, your winner. He's 3 under, and Brian Folk goes 5 under. Next pair, Edward Rudek now. Central Car Clinic sponsored flame vet roadster taking on the older Corvette roadster of James Wilson Sr. Hot Rod, looking for you. Hot Rod, need you rolling. Hot Rod, need you rolling. All right. Good green light start. Wilson out in front, and he will take it, runs dead on, 90 on the 90 with a 2, wins the race by 0.007 seconds, better reaction time is where it was all won, 0.046 for him to an 0.078 for Rudek. Another pair of Corvettes, Steve Ottley, Tower Side, 63 vintage car, replica, Dave Dollum over there in the old 57 style. And Alam out front with a better reaction time at the end of the track. Another double breakout. He's only 1 under at 89 to take the win compared to 2 under for Ottley. Again, Hot Rod looking for you in the lanes. Hot Rod looking for you in the lanes, please. All right, GM versus Ford battle going on right here. Vernon Rowland in the little olds, Calais. This time, corporate 555 power to Dave Johnson in the 09 Mustang. All right, taking our time. Almost identical on the reactions. Only 3,000 separate them. Across the stripe, it's going to go to Rowland. 91 on the 90. As Johnson is 2 off. So 0.001 seconds there, the margin of victory. Pair of Chevrolets here, Camaro in the Clerco Lane, Rich Peisch, I'm going to say Gregory Couch over there in the little Vega. The 90 dial, so despite the better reaction from the Clerco Lane driver. Again, Hot Rod looking for you, Hot Rod looking for you in the lanes. Hot Rod, Hot Rod, Hot Rod.
Such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday.
right, getting ready now, a little Good Vibrations top dragster action. Once again, Hot Rod. Need you rolling up in the lanes, please. Hot Rod, we are looking for you. So you need to roll up, please. We're getting ready now for Good Vibrations top dragster. Top sportsman to follow. So, Anthony Lane, Cold Valley, Illinois, already has one Ironman this weekend. Looking to double up here in this top dragster class. You got Ed Smith on the far side. LaSalle, Ontario, Canada. $720 the dial for Smith on the Curry Transport side. $718 for Lane. He qualified with an 18, and he'll dial it true. Smith qualified with a 37. But in the heat of the day and the way the track feels, he dials down to a 20 on that American build. Red light for Smith, 5,000 feet on the tree. Continuing to try to be one of the only double ups this weekend, as he took a win earlier this morning in our top dragster final from yesterday. Now Bobby Ince and Bill Black, the Ince Towing sponsor. Chassis Comsets built out of Kewanee, Illinois, 7-11 is the dial. Qualified number three spot with the 11, and he'll dial that true. Bill Black, Cedar Rapids, Iowa, the complete automotive-sponsored car. Qualified with a 13, but he put the 686. He ran right around that number at 201 mile an hour yesterday, so he knows the car's capable of running. Identical 027 light. Jack, hold it for him, and yes, it does, dead on. Both cars, 027 lights, both cars dead on the number, but Black will take it at 17 ten thousandths of a second. So, yeah, he knew what that car would do. Wow. Now Chris Sullivan, Auburn, Illinois, big block Chevrolet power dragster, 709. Qualified with a 13, but he's going to step her down just a little bit. Travis C., Bayview, Ohio, qualified with a 41, and he's going to keep the 41 dial. Stock, need you in the lanes now. Stock. Stock. Double O lights for both. Stock eliminator. Top end, it's going to be Sullivan. Travis gets there just a little fast. 3,000s, had it covered big. But Sullivan Family Racing will take that win and head for the next round. Once again, Stock, this is your call. Dennis Lund Jr., the Long Motorsport sponsored dragster out of Bettendorf, Iowa, has Chris Cadle, number two in the world. Carries that number two plate out of Monroe, Michigan. The Nitrous Express UAW sponsored dragster. 200 difference on the dials. You cannot see that on the tree. Human eye can't pick it up. It's going to look heads up as the tree comes down, but there is a 200 difference. Cato gets the jump. Four on the 42, double O on the tree. And now Jacob Elrod, part of that Sunoco stable, coming out of Herod, Ohio. The Total Aquarium maintenance car of Tony Frazier, local racer out of Davenport, Iowa, just across the river. Well, across the river and south a little bit, but across the river nonetheless. good green light. Elrod, big advantage on the tree. Can he hold to the top end? Yes, he does. 37 on the 36th. And takes the win to wrap up that round action. Once again, Stock. Stock, need you in the lanes for pairing. Stock, need you in the lanes. Stock, this is your call. Stock, need you in the lanes for pairing. Once again, Hot Rod and Stock. Hot Rod and Stock, need you in the lanes. Hot Rod and Stock. All right, here we go with the good vibration. Top Sportsman semifinal. Rupert Allman, South Point, Ohio. Chevrolet powered Firebird, qualified number 6 with a 76. He will dial the true 76. Steve Moss on the far side. Also in the Chevrolet powered Firebird out of Minito, Illinois, qualified with a 54. He's going to go 49 for this semifinal round. Hot Rod and Stock. Hot Rod, Stock. This is your call. Advantage on the trees, so probably looked over right there and knew wasn't nobody going to take the line. Now the other half of the semifinal round. This is Jeff Sutherland. Mentioned before, he's tough. That Benson body and paint, nitrous-fed, Chevrolet-powered Cutlass. Qualified with a 73, he'll go 72. And John Hotstetler. Nitrous-fed Mopar, Stratus. Number one qualifier with a 702, and he goes 03. Both of them venting off huge gulps of nitrous oxide, making sure the line is clear so when it comes time, they get nothing but pure juice dumped into that carburetor chamber. Little burn down thing going on here. Now Sutherland rolls in. Neither one wanting to set it up. Third amber.
No matter what you drive, Summit Racing Equipment has great parts at great prices. Summit Racing has the lowest prices guaranteed on the parts, tools, and accessories for high-performance cars and racing, trucks and off-roading, daily drivers, late model vehicles, and more. With over 900 brand-name manufacturers to choose from, you'll always get great parts at great prices. Plus, you'll find money-saving deals on thousands of in-stock parts every day. Get the best parts and accessories for what you drive at Summit Racing. Visit summitracing.com.
America, it's time to rally. It's time to take part in the adventure of a lifetime. We want you and a friend to join us for the AMSOIL America Adventure this October. The week-long rally starts in Deadwood, South Dakota, and wraps up as VIP guests at the Monster Energy Cup in Las Vegas. The trip is more than just a car ride. Each day, the goal is to beat your competition in unique challenges and missions to earn points towards the game's grand prize to be awarded in Vegas. Register at AmsOilRacing.com for your chance to win an all-expenses-paid entry for two into the AmsOil America Adventure.
Continues down to, what is it, semifinals, something like that, quarterfinals. We're getting down there. Roger Van Ersvelde, now Brooklyn, Iowa, in the blue Camaro. Jeff Weitz in the Cuda. Weitz and Son Septic Service. Is who Jeff Weitz would like to thank. And we'll get another chance to come back as Van Ersvelde goes red by 8. Very tight on the tree there, with the Monza coming on quick. Double breakout race. Forrester in the Monza takes it, goes one under compared to six under for Folk. Now Jan Winkowski, in the Lunatic Fringe Nova to take on the Beretta of Dennis Lund Jr. Gets there too quick by a hundredth. Moving into our stock classes. Clairco side of things, Steve Blondell, 87 Camaro, 305 Chevy motor there. Drew Whalen out of Decatur, Lucas Oil Firebird. Oh, let's see, got a half a second difference in dial. Of course, wheels up out of both cars. As we go side by side down the track. And double breakout race with Steve Blondell coming out on top. 5 minute call on race fuel. 5 minute call. You need Sunoco race fuel. You got about 5 minutes to get over and get yours. 5 minute call on race fuel. All right, here's the James Thompson Sr. in the big blue truck taking on Brent Darick out of Hookstown, PA. The white Camaro. Thompson out of Davenport, the local boy. Him way out in front with Darick coming on strong, almost even on the tree here. As we cross the line, it's another double breakout race. This time, James Thompson Jr., your winner, runs one under, 100th under, 92 on the 93. All right, Rob Turkle now pulling up for the by run. He's just down the road a piece, the little burg of Rapid City, Illinois. 1980 Camaro, complete with 350 Chevy. Running to a stop. And a 9-0 is what he dials.
A no-makeup look and feel, and it's clinically proven to promote clearer, healthier-looking skin.
All right, semi-final round of and we find Dennis Foster, Clarco Lane out of Martin Grove, Illinois, taking on Larry Bernshausen over there in the yellow-purple mostly car. Big block power for both of them. I'm going to guess Chevrolet in the tower lane, as he didn't tell me. Well, Bernshausen with advantage on the tree. Jack, it's going to mean the difference. He had a perfect light. And Foster runs one under. Now Rob Bush, Bush Lawn Care sponsored Dragon Asphalt Machine out of Rio, Illinois, to take on Vernon Rowland, the Oklahoma boy from Blanchard. All black car, Chevy powered as well. Going to go to Rowland. Perfect pass there. 90 on the 90. 017 light compared to a .1. So big hole shot there. All right. Semifinal now in Superstock. Top Dragster looking for you. Top Dragster. Good vibrations. Top Dragster. You can bring them up to the lanes, please. Good vibrations, Top Dragster, looking for you. All right, blue cars, both sides, General Motors. The Firebird is Matt Lund out of Bettendorf. Scott Stillings in the little Grand Am. Very close on reactions. Scott Stillings runs 08 on the 04. Super Rod and Top Dragster now looking for you. Super Rod and Top Dragster looking for you up in the lanes. Next up, Jason DeForest. Andover, Minnesota is home for him. He's a production manager up there. He's in the bright red Cavalier. And Bill Dyer, the local boy out of Port Byron in the old 85 Mustang. He's away first. Wow, great lights for both of our drivers here. We got ourselves a stripe. It's a double breakout one. David Dahlin pulls up the old 57 Corvette replica against James Wilson Sr. in the 63 version. Going to be Dahlem's race. Wilson gets there too quick by 300s. Your next pair in the Olds Calais is Vernon Rowland, the Oklahoma kid, taking on Greg Couch. Hot Rod, Hot Rod, again looking for you, Hot Rod, looking for you. Couch out of Bettendorf. Almost identical on the tree. And a great side-by-side race with Rowland, your winner, dead on with a four compared to Greg Couch's one off, 91 on the 90. 012 light to an 014, so 2,000s, ain't much difference there. Okay, so the Byron here in the little Vega wagon, Larry Bernhausen out of Menido, Illinois. 407 cubic inch Chevrolet. Quick Rod, Quick Rod, this is your call, Quick Rod. Need you to the lanes, Quick Rod. Final round, Quick Rod. Need you up in the lanes, please. So, Stock, need you for pairings. Stock, need you for pairings. Stock racers, need you to the back of the lanes for your pairings. Semi-final round.
So once again, we need Stock semifinal, Quick Rod final. Stock semifinal, Quick Rod final, Super Stock final. Bring them all in. Here we go, a little semifinal action now. This is our quarterfinal, pardon me, in our top dragster class. Only one looking to be able to double up. This is Anthony Lane, still going strong, took a win yesterday. Trying to walk away with two Ironman this weekend, but he's got his hands full. In Bill Black, the complete automotive sponsored car out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. 717, the dial for Lane. He has not changed since round one. 687 for Black. He was the number two qualifier. In that racecraft built car. So Lane has already put the number one qualifier. On the tree, took the stripe by 8,000, and he is moving on. Chris Sullivan, the Racecraft chassis built big black Chevrolet car out of Auburn, Illinois. Jacob Elrod on the far side, the Herod Ohio Sunoco team. The Elrod Racing family. Once again, we need Hot Rod Stock, Quick Rod, Hot Rod Semi, Stock Semi, Quick Rod Final, Super Stock Final. You can bring them in. Hot Rod Stock, Super Stock to the lane. Double O reaction time for both of these. Top end, it is Elrod. Dead on with a 7:015 package headed toward the semifinals here today. And now the single carrying that number two plate out of Monroe, Michigan. The Knights Express sponsored car of Chris Cadle. 7:40 to the dial. That is what he qualified with. Again, Hot Rod Semifinal, Stock Semifinal, Quick Rod Final, Super Stock Final. Bring them into the lanes, please. This is your call. Hot Rod, Stock, Quick Rod, Super Stock. Need them rolling. So Cato goes 0-16 on the tree. 42 the dial. He lifts out, goes 8:05. You could just hear that motor go. No, I don't think I want to finish the run. We've got the Midwest Super Cup Association, Midwest Top Sports Association, and the Bluegrass Band, Frank F. Skinner's, or Frank F. Sidney's Western Bandit Volunteers. A great bluegrass band going to be playing here, all for free. So spectators, come on out and enjoy the night. All right, Hot Rod Semifinal now, Jan Winkonski. Another driver trying to double up. He was in a final earlier today. The Lunatic Fringe car. The Nova out of Chictanagua, New York. Jeff Wheat on the far lane. 1090 racer here in the Midwest. Almost everybody at one time is lined up against that Barracuda. The Wheats and Sons RK Racing. Hunter Auto Body sponsored car. Winkonski gets the jump on the tree, but breaks out on the top end. As Weeks runs dead on 90. On the 90, he's headed to the finals here today. And now Patrick Forrester, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the Sunoco Race Fuels car. Oh, he's on the Sunday afternoon parade run there. He's not setting no numbers down. He's waving to the fans. Throwing candy, I think, as he goes by. That's a parade route run. 13, still ran a 90. It was just a 1390 instead of a 1090. But all he's got to do is go down the track. He's headed for a final today now also. All right, we're still going to need our Stock Semifinal, Quick Rod Final, Super Stock Final, Top Sportsman Final. You should all be in the lanes and all your other cars. We're at the point, you cool it, you fuel it, you bring it back. That's where we are. Cool it, fuel it, bring it back. Super Rod Semifinal, bring it back. Top Dragster Semifinal, bring it back. We're at the point here, call it Round Robin. Call it, come on up and race. Call it whatever you want, but I'm calling cars. So you win, bring it back. Cool it, fuel it, and come on. Semi-final action now in our stock eliminator class. Steve Blondell, number one qualifier from yesterday. High stock automatic Camaro out in Illinois facing the eighth stock Camaro. Wide circle out of Rapid City. So the battle of the Illinois Camaros. Oh, and Blondell in trouble. Turkle looks back, saw it, stepped on it. Not sure what happened to Blondell, but right about half track, it just turned loose on him. And so ran into a problem with that iStock automatic. Not sure what the problem was, but he was definitely done early. So Jim Thompson Sr. now driving that Jim Peterson owned E-Truck stock automatic out of Davenport, Iowa. We'll take the bye. So it will be two local racers, Iowa versus Illinois, Turkle and Thompson, in our stock final here this afternoon. Quick Rod final, super stock final. Need them up in the lanes. To the starting line. Do they know how to take care of their workers here at Cordova International Raceway? Huh? Gonna stop racing long enough for everybody to have a little Dairy Queen. Isn't that nice?
We've got our own soft serve machine now down in the food stand.
But we're not gonna hold up racing. We're gonna go right into a final here. This is the Super Stock Final. Defending world champion Scott Stillings, the A-modified Grand Am out of Floyd Knobs, Indiana. Taking on the Cavalier out of Andover, Minnesota, Jason DeBoer, TTV Automatic. And this is the Super Stock Final. Good green light from the trap top end. It's going to be DeForest for the win, 26 on the 24. The Arrow Awnings, Billet Specialties, Arrow Fab Incorporated. Number one qualifying car at 1.31 seconds under the national index takes the win light. Congratulations. All right. Good vibrations. Top Sportsman Final coming out now. I mentioned before, Farlane John Hodge-Stedler. A runner-up already this weekend in that nitrous-fed Mopar-powered Stratus out of Niles, Michigan. 7.06 to dial, qualified with an 0.02. He's got Steve Moss, who had so many problems yesterday. He drugged the laundry down the track on three passes. Not today. They've got it all taken care of. The nitrous-fed Chevrolet-powered Firebird out of Manito, qualified number two. With a 7.54, he dials the 54, so it's number one qualifier. The nitrous-fed Stratus facing the number two qualifier in that nitrous-fed Chevrolet. This is our Good Vibrations Top Sportsman Final, and watch for Hodge-Stedler on the far lane. Will he walk away with two runner-ups? Or is he going to get a winner and runner-up? We are about to find out. So again, congratulations to John Hodge-Stedler. A winner and a runner-up in this Good Vibrations Top Sportsman class. That nitrous-fed Mopar has a great showing for itself. All right, looks like Quick Rod final now. Our 890 class is going to be Vernon Rowland out of Blanchard, Oklahoma. The Universal Roofing, white safety, Mickey Thompson sponsored, Mondin built dragster. He's got Larry Bird Thompson. Doubled up all weekend, driving the little Monza wagon and hot rod and the dragster here at Quick Rod. The Auto Plus Parts Stores Crew Chief Pro sponsored, Chevrolet powered, Gebhardt built. Dragster out of Menito, Illinois. Qualified number 4, 89.6. Roland qualified in the number 5 spot with an 89.0. 890, the number they're looking for. Quick Rod final now. Again, Super Rod semifinal, top dragster semifinal. Got to get up here, please. Top Rod final, stock final. We'll take you. Red light by Bird Chalkton. 1/1000th of a second. Roland going to get the win, and he runs a 9.01. All right, here we go now. Good Vibrations top dragster semifinal. Chris Cadel, number 2 in the world out of Monroe, Michigan. Qualified with a 42. He puts a 42 on the car. Bill Black on the Curry Transport side. The complete automotive sponsored car out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Qualified with a 713, but he'll go 88. On the dial in, and he's been running that number pretty much all day long, and it's brought him to the semifinals here. The 41 black, they both fall off the dial, but Chris Cadel is headed for the finals here today in Good Vibrations top dragster, and he will face Jacob Elrod, the Elrod Racing Team, part of that Sunoco Race Fuel state out of Herod, Ohio, and he will bump in and back out. All he's required to do is take the tree, and that's all he does.
Oh, I used to roll. Not anymore. Whatever. But you can make a difference. Go to freeradioonmyphone.org to find out how to get real radio on your phone. Tell them Estrada sent you.
This is your summer. The summer
you're all right, final. Stock final. Need you up here, please. Still sponsored. Monza out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Number 3 qualifier here in the Clerco Tower Lane. He's got Jeff Weeks. The Weeks and Son Septic Service, RK Racing, Hunter Body Shop and Towing, sponsor Barracuda, out of Morrison, Illinois, qualified the number 9 spot. So this is the finals of our 1090 Hot Rod class. Good green light for both. Throttle stops, let go, almost the same spot. Top end, your winner tonight is Jeff Weeks, 11.01 on the 1090 dial. Congratulations to the Big Barracuda out of Morrison, Illinois. All right, looks like it's going to be the finals now in our stock eliminator. Yep, as they rolled around the corner, that is James Thompson Jr. driving the Jim Peterson pickup truck. Look like that big Jim right there in front of him. E-truck stock automatic. Thompson Jr. driving the big Dodge out of Davenport, Iowa. Qualified with a 1289. He'll dial an 86. Another local racer. That's Rob Turkle, the H-stock Camaro out of Rapid City, Illinois. Qualified the number 11 spot with a 48, and he will dial the 48. Turkle will chase Thompson Jr. This is the stock eliminator final. So Junior had his work cut out no matter what. He would have had to have driven that thing right to where it, dead on, as Rob Turkle saves his best run of the weekend for the championship round. 48 with a zero on the 48, 003 on the tree, 003 package. Thompson Jr., 16,000 quick on the tree. And was a thou heavy or a thou light on the top end as he ran an 85.9. So he had it dialed. Just jumped the tree a little tiny bit. Congratulations to Rob Turkle. All right, Super Rod semifinal coming out. And don't forget, we got that big North Star Super Rod bonus in effect. The Division III Super Rod bonus, the winner walking away with an extra $750, $250 going to the runner-up here in our Super Rod class today. Top Dragster final, need you back. Top Dragster will take you up in the finals, please. So here we go. Semi-final action of the Super Rod class. Dave Dollum, Tremont, Illinois, qualified number 13 with a 93. The Corvette Roadster facing the little Vega wagon. Larry Bernschotzen, qualified number 17 with 89.2 out of Manito, Illinois. Throttle stop as he runs a 30 against the 90. There's the problem there. Dollum was right on a 98 on the 90 run. I thought he had problems, but no, I'm looking at everything. It was Bernschossen that left the throttle stop off, apparently, as he runs a 930 against the 990. And now this will be Vernon Rowland, the Oldsmobile Callus. Clay taking the bye run, headed into a final here today. Top Dragster final will take you. Top Dragster final. You can roll them up in the lanes, please. Top Dragster final to the lane. On the tree, breaks through the top end with a 98.
No
No matter what you drive, Summit Racing Equipment has great parts at great prices. Summit Racing has the lowest prices guaranteed on the parts, tools, and accessories for high-performance cars and racing, trucks and off-roading, daily drivers, late model vehicles, and more. With over 900 brand-name manufacturers to choose from, you'll always get great parts at great prices. Plus, you'll find money-saving deals on thousands of in-stock parts every day. Get the best parts and accessories for what you drive at Summit Racing. Visit SummitRacing.com.
America, it's time to rally. It's time to take part in the adventure of a lifetime. We want you and a friend to join us for the AMSOIL America Adventure this October. The week-long rally starts in Deadwood, South Dakota, and wraps up as VIP guests at the Monster Energy Cup in Las Vegas. The trip is more than just a car ride. Each day, the goal is to beat your competition in unique challenges and missions to earn points towards the game's grand prize to be awarded in Vegas. Register at AMSOILRacing.com for your chance to win an all-expenses-paid entry for two into the AMSOIL America Adventure.
Express, Extreme Paint UAW Region 1A sponsored dragster, qualified with a 42, we'll put a 43 on it for the final. He's got Jacob Elrod, Harrod, Ohio, part of that Sunoco race team, qualified with a 36, puts a 34 on the car for the finals. So here we go. Good Vibrations, top dragster final. Elrod in the Sunoco car will chase number two. Hammered on the tree. Here we go. On the top end, your winner is going to be Elrod. 39 on the 34. Cato goes 47 on the 43. And he's going to have Vernon Rowland, the Universal Roofing and Sheet Metal sponsored Oldsmobile out of Blanchard, Oklahoma. Qualified number 19 with an 88 against the 90. So 990 the dial. Last pair of the weekend, Super Rod Final. Not only the winner's money, but $750 bonus going to the winner, not $250 bonus to the runner-up. Corvette facing Oldsmobile. Here we go. Green light start for both. Dahlem gets the jump on the tree. Trying to take the Roadster the full length.
No matter what you drive, Summit Racing Equipment has great parts at great prices. Summit Racing has the lowest prices guaranteed on the parts, tools, and accessories for high-performance cars and racing, trucks and off-roading, daily drivers, late model vehicles, and more. With over 900 brand-name manufacturers to choose from, you'll always get great parts at great prices. Plus, you'll find money-saving deals on thousands of in-stock parts every day. Get the best parts and accessories for what you drive at Summit Racing. Visit summitracing.com.
America, it's time to rally. It's time to take part in the adventure of a lifetime. We want you and a friend to join us for the AMSOIL America Adventure this October. The week-long rally starts in Deadwood, South Dakota, and wraps up as VIP guests at the Monster Energy Cup in Las Vegas. The trip is more than just a car ride. Each day, the goal is to beat your competition in unique challenges and missions to earn points towards the game's grand prize to be awarded in Vegas. Register at AMSOILRacing.com for your chance to win an all-expenses-paid entry for two into the AMSOIL America Adventure.